Everyone's attention, please. Hello, hello. Hello. Anyway, it was a year and a half ago, March 17th of 2015. My wife, Tony, right here. We walked up past this place and we saw the chains on the M&M and subconsciously looked at each other and they said, this is not right. This place needs to be open. And then so she bit my arm and made me go make a deal to try to buy this place. And then I asked her to get in person and help me out with some money. Soon after that, in May, from a gentleman in Bozeman and actually owned the real estate, and went to the courthouse steps and bought the rest of it that came with it. And from that time, we've been working on putting the staff together, commanding, putting on things, doing what we had to do. And then we had something we would call a soft opening. Someone so soft, it was about this big a crowd on a Christmas stroll on December 4th. And so it took that long. And then from December 4th for about 2 more weeks, and then we opened up food. The tradition lived on. We had a bar, we had food. The tradition lived on by a Super Bowl. We had full tabs. The tradition lived on, and after the full tabs, we came back and put BGMs in, and we got video games going on back here. And the casino was open. And the tradition lives on that in 1 week, we're going to have horse racing live. And so May 7th at Kentucky Derby, come back on the podium. And I think I'm going to turn this mic over to Dave, and then we'll get into the ribbon cutting, etc. But I'd like to introduce you to my director of operations. And I found him by accident, actually. I have to tell you the truth. It was by accident. But and how do you like this mic? Doesn't it remind you of those first thing back in the days of the old M&M? Love this mic. Yes. We bought this in the closet. No, this actually belongs to Dan Lawson, our bar manager, but he brought it out for us today. And I'm going to introduce you now to Dave Andrews, my director of operations for both the M&M and Metal Sports Bar. So welcome, Dave Andrews. He's your man, put it all together.
Everybody for coming. We would really like to thank everybody for the support. We'd like to thank everybody for the support that you've given us. I've got to think, I can't talk louder, I got a cold.
Come on this way.
Yeah, come on.
Everybody can come this way. We're not shy back here. But we would just like to thank everybody for the continued support. We've had the business has exceeded our expectations. And we take customer service very personal here. So if anybody ever has a problem or an issue or anything like that, please, I'm available 24/7. I work for a distributor, so I have no life. Other than that, I would like to thank, we've got some people here. We've got Greg and Gary from Montana Room and Brush. I see Mark Kubovich from Food Services of America. We've got Reagan from the Montana Standard. This wasn't an easy undertaking. I think Ray and I spent about 45 days before I decided to sign on, and I haven't looked back since. I want to thank him from the bottom of my heart, as well as Tony. It has been a labor of love, and there have been some good days, and there was a few bad ones when we were trying to get open because of the... there was a little bit of a... stigmatism with the M&M, and I think everybody knows a little bit about that, but we're not dwelling on the past, we're looking forward to the future. So anyway, we've got some giveaways we're going to be doing. We've got some cocktails out there, we've got some complimentary appetizers, some hors d'oeuvres, and we have some desserts. So let me turn it over to Marco, and just a sincere thank you for everybody for coming.
Before we get
going, I'm going to go to Jerry Everett from Main Street. Say a few words, and then we'll go on with Jerry Everett. Here's
yours.
Thank you. Kino, BE7. I appreciate the opportunity to say a couple words about this place. A couple years ago, probably the saddest thing I ever saw was St. Patrick's Day with a group of people tugging on the front door, and was locked up and shuttered, and It's just something that should have never happened and hopefully will never happen again. And I'm sure that the people who are running it now won't let that happen for quite a while. This place is a tradition. We need new businesses uptown, but we need old businesses made new again, and this is one of them. And it just it has a bright future, but it also has a tradition and a past that goes way back till it was called the Cigar Store, because they sold cigars and a few other things along with it. But also, people have come through those doors. People like Barack Obama, when he was running for president. Brian Schweitzer did a shot of Bushmills, which I wish I had one of those right now. All the way back to Jack Kerouac, who took a bus trip across the United States, ended up in Butte, decided that this place was probably the best bar he'd ever been in the United States of America. And I have to say, I go back to where I had breakfast here, and Stevie Faulkner did my dishes, so that's how long I've been coming here. And I look forward to coming here for many years to come. And something about tradition that I just wanted to mention too that I saw in a few years is that there used to be miners in here in the earliest days when I come in, they'd be sitting drinking at the bar. But then I started to notice, I'd be over here at Heritage Park or somewhere, and there'd be these parents bringing their children in here to have steaks or to have breakfast or whatever. And it became a tradition which actually since this is opened again, I've seen that come back. And people, I see Sunday mornings, Uptown Butte is busy again. And I'm gonna have to give the blame to Ray and to Tony and to all the crew here and just say thank you so much for doing this and good luck and bless you very much. Thank you.
I went back to Broadway, but he just reminded me of a couple of things that I had a compliment coming out this week, and he says, how come you waited until this long before it ran open? You've been open since December. Well, actually, we've just been practicing getting ready for tonight, and we're going to be officially open now. We've been practicing for the last 4 months, and a big compliment that I got also from one of George's downtown people. They were talking about the tradition, and they said, you know, we still have the garbage outlet here, and back to Elsie's Diner. Elsie's still got her namesake above the thing, and we're not taking it down above the kitchen. And we still got the ground round cheeseburgers, so you can get those good old traditions. But she said to me, she said, I never thought I'd live long enough to see strawberry crepes at the M&M. That's a true story that was said to me Tuesday. And so, anyway, back to Marco.
Ambassadors, you want to come up here so we can really get the point.
We're going to do this on the count of three now, so 1, 2, 3. Hey! The bar is now known as a bicycle racer and help Rayanos.